So the Atithi, the guest is also asking for food, your beggar is also demanding food, and your son is also asking for food. You are going to feed them. First, for a beggar, he will be placed in his respective place, he will be given his respective food and in the center. And an Atithi, a guest, will be formally invited, given on seat, not only given the food asked, but also some extra support. But for your son, you will give not only food, regular food, care, comfort, give your properties, everything. Yes. Yes, undemanded. Ayachita phala. Means asking. Ayachita phala mapi dadati mahata. Then you need not demand these things. You need not ask for these things. Likewise, a mere preacher gives you the benefits of the book. Whatever there is a book that you can read. And if you arise any doubts, he will clarify within his limited exposure. And secondly, a philosopher treats you like an atithi. Not only the book contents, the subtleties of the book and values of the book will also be important. If you are going to a hotel, they will give just only food. There are two basic requirements or two basic requisite instincts before the consumption and after the consumption of food. The preconsumptive and find the prerequisite for having the food. Appetite, she will kindle that appetite by giving ginger or some other appetizer. If it is not digested, she will give some other supportive element for digestion. So, that is the difference between preaching and your preceptorial influence. An acharya and a shikshaka or adhyapaka. So, an acharya, the margadarshaka, the torchbearer of the society, not only is giving you knowledge, but if you are devoid of the appetite for knowledge, he kindles the appetite. If you cannot assimilate it, he makes you to assimilate, realize, the practice and achieve it. He sees that you achieve it. Not that we require thousands of preachers, but at least we require at least a dozen of preceptors for creating a renaissance in the society, resulting in all around happiness and prosperity. That is what Karats are told in his value-added education. What is that value? That value is nothing but, see, there are a lot of cyphers, there is only one. That one that vivifies that cipher to get some value. What is that value? That value is not professional value or higher academic persuasion to the time immemorial cyclic vicious circles of poverty, racism, religious clashes, communal clashes, and other ugliness of this society. So that is what we require now. And this is the work of social intelligence. Right? Military intelligence is defined to be the intelligence of the military people, intelligence of the military people, about the military operations. Social intelligence is intelligence of the society about the social operations. That is the basic root cause of a person's depression, failure and everything. It is the root cause of all miseries, as told by Buddha. Desire, unless if it is kept under the lotus feet of the Almighty, the inexhaustible source of desire and bliss, all the other rest sources of desire, they are nothing but melancholy in disguise. So, that particular desire, that is not every prudential phenomenon by which we can operate the social system. For example, you are going to a medical shop. There, if you want to purchase any medicine for eradication of any predicament, you will go as per the prescription of a doctor who has diagnosed you, who has interpreted.